Hello, I'm Bob Egan of Pop Spots, the website where I track down where old record album covers were made. Today, we're going to look at Bob Dylan's Bringing It All Back Home. Now, today I'm on Minetta Street in Greenwich Village, the center of the folk movement, and I'm standing next to what was used to be called the Commons. In 1962, Dylan wrote Blowing in the Wind right here. Now, back in that era, he was a scruffy-looking kid who just blew in from the Midwest, and he would be photographed that way. But 3 years later, he's a changed guy. Rock and roll has come, the Beatles have come, the Rolling Stones have come, new fashions have come. When he put out this album, he's dressed like a country squire. He's in the middle of a nice, beautiful house with next to a beautiful woman. He's got a Persian cat. Basically, what he's trying to do here is say, I'm past the folk movement, I'm moving on. As a matter of fact, half the record is acoustic, that's the old world, and half is electric. Right here, this is Sally Grossman. Bob's manager was Albert Grossman, and that was his wife. This photograph is taken on the Grossman's estate up in Bearsville, New York, which is just west of Woodstock.
How many pictures did you take like this?
10.
And how did you decide on this particular shot?
The only one in which the cat was looking at the lens.
No, how did you get that yellow circle of light?
I explained to Bob that what would happen if we do this effect, we will have things blurry and moving.
Yeah.
But you won't be moving because you're the center.
Yeah.
You know what's going on. But around you, there's the turning of the world, also the turning of the record.
Any reason why you put Dylan's own album in the back, just kind of like his history? Is that it? My back pages?
Bob put a lot of things in that had some meaning for him.
Bob Dylan with Daniel Kramer, they spent about 3 hours going through the house, just picking up all sorts of old stuff, including the record album and, you know, movies, and then, you know, like old world paintings. He's got these pink cufflinks, and they were presented to him by Joan Baez. And he's got, you know, a lot of the objects that of his past, including one of his old albums in the middle.